Hey guys, it's Marlon here. If this is the first time you guys watching my video, I just want to thank you and ask you to subscribe. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button and the notification bell as well. Make sure you like the video and you share it and all them wonderful stuff there. So today I am actually just leaving my house to go and for the first time go to dining with Curvy. That's on 35 Dunrobin Road or Avenue, whatever it's called. But yeah, that's where I'm going right now. Kind of check out how the place stay, how the food stays, see if it's a good vibe, give a little review. But yeah, so guys, stay tuned. Hopefully you enjoy this video. People now say them antisocial because them don't like socialize a lot, but they're not really antisocial, they're antisocial. Yeah. Asocial, which is a completely different thing. Antisocial, he was saying, it means that you do so things that are not socially acceptable, and it causes problems in your socialization setting. But asocial just means that you really prefer your own company and stuff like that. And this is an experience, because right now, for me, I'm actually having to deal with being asocial and now putting myself out there to be more sociable and finding that balance, as a new YouTuber and stuff like that. So this is like part of my experience, you guys coming with me to see how an asocial person who socialized, yes, but only socialized and planned, now have to deal with socializing, being a part of our YouTube audience and social media space. So guys, hopefully this video is going to be entertaining and stuff for you. See ya! I don't know how some people this driving and vlogging at the same time, but yo, my mind was a little bit distracted.
This is where I come in. So you come in, you know, I really see nothing, I say Danny with Curvy or Yanique Curvy Diva or nothing like that. But you come in and you look to your right, and you can basically see the car wash place, and then inside the car wash place you can see dining with Curvy. So yeah, that's all you have to go in the place. I didn't want to go in the place yet for look, because I'm going to get my car washed as well. But yeah, so this is dining with Curvy.
Alright, so this is it from the entrance. So this is the outside part. Yeah, subscribe. I can't see them, but y'all know. So yeah.
Hi.
Excuse me, hey, what's up?
My name is
Marlon.
Hi Marlon, nice to meet you.
Yeah, what's your name?
Hi, my name is Nneka. Can I tell you about my YouTube
channel? Of course, what's your YouTube channel about?
Okay, so I do vlogs, I do hauls, I try wearing stuff, I pierce my ears myself, I try to wax myself.
Ooh, what am I piercing your ears?
I don't know. I go down more.
You only pierce your ears, right?
I pierce my nose one time, but it's not pierced
yet. Okay.
Hi everybody, subscribe to my YouTube channel, Nneka Toni.
Thank you.
So yeah, guys, I'm going to come back to you. My waitress is here. You see all this service? She's standing up here.
Hi.
Yeah,
as I said before, welcome to Danny with Curvy. I'm Kimon, so due to the whole COVID situation, we don't have a physical menu to present, but I can tell you what's on the menu. So go to put on my tray and then come back to you, right?
One of my brethren them was basically trying to define me, because I say, yo, I'm antisocial. And most people normally say, yo, I'm antisocial, I'm not really socializing with people, man. Toni. Hi, Yanique. Of course, guys. Yanique is here. Guys, Yanique is here.
You get the best angles, okay?
Yanique, all angles for you are the best. I'm telling you the truth. I know I've been watching all of your videos. A lot of the videos that I'm seeing for you and a lot of different YouTubers channels. I decided I had to come here today.
Oh my goodness.
So that's one of the main reasons why I'm here today. Yeah.
Hey. So you
ordered? I ordered a chicken parmesan.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So eat it out before you set the video. Make sure your video, because I know it will smell good.
No,
good.
Taste good. Give them good afternoon to the food, but I make sure they're
good. Nice.
That's why you're cooking it very well. I know that I have to come for it so you can cook for me. You know that's an invitation, right?
I know.
Hey guys.
Hi.
Alright, thanks. Guys, Yanique is awesome, guys. Yo, that was like a photo bomb of my life right there. I know. But yeah, so as I was saying, hello.
Hi guys, I'm here with Nneka.
I just told her I'm asocial. I know a lot of Jamaicans, we don't know that. But I learned it by my friend last week, who kind of diagnosed me as well.
Alright, so we had to change location because of the noise, and then you can tell about copyright and all them kind of things here, so not around here for it. Alright, so I was telling her that asocial, because she just look at my IG page and all of that, and so what's the question you asked?
I'll ask you, what does that mean? What does asocial or asocial say, whatever, what does that mean?
Can I just take it off completely?
I heard
her say panoramic.
We're in a panoramic,
guys.
We're in a Panasonic.
A Panasonic?
Panera bread.
Panera bread. No.
Honestly.
I'm focused on today. Like, the difficulty for asocial people, actually. Be social, especially now, like, as a YouTuber.
Yeah.
You know, do a good job so far?
Yeah, you're doing great.
You could have told that I'm asocial?
No, I actually couldn't. I really couldn't.
So, okay. So I'm here by myself and you couldn't tell us that
being
so
true. I was wondering, like, why is he here by himself? And I thought you were with the other YouTubers in the back.
Are there YouTubers there?
Yeah.
That big group over there?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. It's a YouTube day or something.
Guys.
Yeah.
It's a YouTube day today. So if you have a YouTube channel, today's the day to do it.
Or any other day. 35 Don Robin Avenue, dining with Curvy. Thank you.
Alright, that's a plug right there. But guys, for real, come down to dining with Curvy. It's been fun so far. Even as an asocial person, socializing and stuff, it's still been fun. That might be another thumbnail, part of the thumbnail.
Oh no. Wait now.
Alright, freeze.
I don't know.
What you do?
I don't know.
Alright, that's it. Too much of it now. So guys, yeah, so far been meeting other YouTubers as well. You want to shout out your channel? What's your channel?
Moyamoy's Kitchen.
Yes. Alright guys, so yeah, been meeting YouTubers all day today, and they're doing a YouTube as well. But yeah, definitely go ahead and subscribe to their channel as well. It seems pretty interesting. They do restaurant hops. You guys know me, I like going to restaurants. It's a pretty cool concept. So I'm also subscribed to them, so yeah. And I'm trying my best to socialize and all this kind of stuff, so it's as it is.
Oh,
yeah. So they shout in me out as well. Yeah, this is cool.
Hey guys! Make sure you like and subscribe.
So yeah, it's interesting. Yeah.
Okay. So funny enough, today's video is kind of looking at how an asocial person is able to interact and socialize, just going out and stuff like that. So I'm kind of looking at persons who have like problems socializing or difficulties socializing,
and giving them like a first hand experience of how an asocial person is able to and is able to socialize and basically deal with the challenge of being asocial.
Yeah.
So I'm doing a good job so far. Please. All right, thanks.
How much usually when you go out?
They go with people, right?
Yeah. So probably that would be the wrong thing that would say,
aren't you? So for my videos, I tend to invite a friend or two to be a part of the experience. But by myself, outside of videos, I'm always like in my own space.
By yourself, you have to cope with the socialize with other people.
Yeah. So that's the only hint that I was an asocial person, just being alone. Alright, so guys, the next time that you're going to see me is when we have the food and the drinks. I'll make you guys see how they do it at Dining with Curvy and how the food tastes and what the experience is like. Giving him a rundown and all that. So yeah, we'll see then.
That means you're a lot good. Alright. Okay. Thank you.
So guys, the food there, what did I buy? I ordered the chicken parmesan. Oops, we fix this. So yeah, I ordered the chicken parmesan that's here. And of course, the pina colada and lemon verde and stuff like that. So, we had a little tasting and see what's going on. Alright, so here, I'm kind of getting lost in another video right now. Because I'm going to do a try record and my mind up on the food really. I mean, really, I try to focus on the recording, but I'm completely lost everything I'm going to do. So, I'm going to have to record over and tell you guys, yo, the food bad, the food tastes good, the food amazing. Social, antisocial people, and what does it mean to be asocial in a social world? So, you know, say with the world that we live in, we have to socialize with people and stuff like that. But you have some people who find it difficult to socialize because of different awkwardness or insecurities or trauma that they had to deal with as a child. Or probably could be a personality thing. I'm not a psychologist per se, but it possibly could just be just their particular innate personality that they probably just born with and grow with. But yeah, we do have some persons who find it difficult to socialize and sometimes even awkward to socialize, you know what I mean? So basically those persons, they don't normally put themselves in positions to go out, to make friends and stuff like that. And as you know, this month is really focused on friends and friendship for me. And there's a difficulty with actually having friendships and making friends if you're an asocial person, because you don't put yourself in situations where you actually invest in friendship. Yeah, you probably have persons there who you're nice to, who you're friendly with, but when it comes to investing in a friendship, say, all right, you're going to make the effort to call this person, you're going to make the effort to invite this person out or to be invited out to that
to a place with this person, or just seeing the person in the same space and going up and initiating conversation and engaging in conversation for the purpose of actually, you know, enjoying the person, enjoying your time with a person in your space and stuff like that. So asocial persons have that big difficulty.
I was sharing this in a video that I was doing, the video about friendship, the first video I was doing regarding friendship this month, where I was talking about this instance that happened where one of my friends, in fact, she was probably my first crush, was there playing games with her, and a bee sting me. Yeah, a bee, not that was a bee sting me. I mean, a ball, I'm a run to this girl, like, I'm a look up to her, and she was like the apple of my eye. Now, mama, they really like this girl. Don't ask me why I like her, I don't know. Mama, they just gravitate towards her. I'm gonna go to her and tell her, hey, the bee sting me. And my girl look for me and say, a good. And I don't know, even as me I say it right now, coming like as soon as she say a good, it's like something just slap me with a brick in my chest and my mind and my body all at the same time. And it's like a big reality check that, whoa, man, I wow go on here. So yeah, it just licked me and I was stunned. I was like, whoa, Lego this. And literally after that, I stopped thinking about people as really being interested in my own life and my well-being and caring about me and interested in me or want to talk to me or anything like that. But I was very, 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 very young when that happened. And that incident shaped my perspective even to this day in terms of how I view friends and friendship, where in the sense that I don't necessarily think that persons have a genuine interest in me as a friend. So therefore I don't put out that effort, and I learned from then to not express my issues or my qualms or my feelings to somebody, but keep those inside because I'm the only person who really did it for me. And that developed my asocial tendencies, you know, where I rather not to socialize, I rather not to express my feelings and those kind of stuff like that to friends, and not invest my time, you know, in friends. Cause at the end of the day, what you get? You get some selfish people who just want them own things. That's my mindset. Not right now, cause I have some really good friends now. You know, like I'm not calling a name, cause I know I miss out. Nobody name and nobody go back. But yeah, I have some really good friends now who seem very genuine. And I really respect how much them care for me, how much concern them have, because it's not until later on in my life where I realize that, yeah, you have persons who care about what I'm doing with my life, who care about the decisions that I'm making, who care about, you know, being invested and spending time with me, you know, when it comes to that place where, in fact, it was hard for me, because when persons start deciding they want to spend time with me, it was so awkward, like, why you want to spend time with me? Because I got so used to being my own company. So I'm like, in my head, I'm like, why do you want to spend time with me? You know, cause me no see no purpose in that. You don't really like me anyway. What aim or objective you have? You know, so that is a little bit of stuff for shape me, and some stuff that I'm still dealing with. A lot of it I have been able to get over. You know, as I mentioned, church and school and work really gave me opportunities to be social and sociable, and really start trying to engage with people on a more friendly level with a friendship objective. You know, but it's really now since the month of March now that we're in, I'm really thinking about friends and friendship and putting in the time and effort to be intentionally sociable, you know, and create intentional and meaningful friends and friendships in my life. That brother, yeah, like, him see me in the land, he said, drive around because he's smarter than the world. Yeah, so that's what I wanted to explain, you know, the difficulty that asocial people have in terms of socializing and making friends and maintaining meaningful friendships. Intentionally try to socialize, be yourself, and find what triggers that may have resulted in your asocial behaviors, your asocial tendencies, so that you can purposefully address it. But asocial people, listen, you have to be intentional
about your socializing. You do have to start, say you want to socialize with million people every day, but make a step, make an effort, as in be yourself, don't be afraid. The people will laugh off of you. Don't be afraid to be goofy. Don't be afraid for people to criticize you. Those things aren't healthy things for you to fear. Yeah, it's good that you know it's gonna happen, but the moment you start feeling fearful of it, you just need to let go of it. People will criticize you, they will do all them kind of stuff there, but don't focus on that, don't dwell on that. That's a part of life, nobody gonna like you, but you want a real friend them who really appreciate you for you to really stick around, because them see you. Some really amazing friends might be out there for you to experience, but if you never allow yourself to be yourself, to be true to yourself, to be authentic, they'll never know who you are and that they actually like being around you for what you do for them and for what you do to them and how you make them feel. So that's it for me.
Alright guys, so I'm home now, finally home. It's been a long day on the road. Visited Dining with Curvy. The place was nice. I definitely liked the atmosphere. The food was delish. And of course, I got to meet Yanique. You know, I've been posting up Yanique and watching her videos like all week. So even from last week, you know, because trust me, boy, I completely fall completely in love with Yanique over the past couple weeks. And it was just really a nice experience and coincidence running into her. Like, I really didn't expect her to be at the restaurant. So now I really see why them call it Dining with Curvy, because Curvy really did it. She did it. Yeah, she surprised me, and I was literally taken aback and off guard, you know, at her presence there, and her just coming up to me and just having conversation and talking and just being trust me, yo, her vibe nice. Her vibe is really nice, you know. Yeah, it was an awesome experience. And then after that, I did some errands and I'm finally reaching home. So you were with me for the first part, the Dining with Curvy part, you know. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you're here, thank you so much for watching to the end. Trust me, I appreciate it a lot. And I'm trying to be on my way to my first 1,000 subscribers. I'm going to ask you to help me. How are you going to help me? I just want to ask you to go ahead and first like this video. Once you've done that, comment something nice. Let me know what's your favorite part of this video. Comment it down below. And also, go ahead and subscribe if you haven't done so before. Click the subscribe button and the notification bell. And another really important thing, share this video with your friends. Go ahead and share it with your friends. That's the way how you're going to help me. Apart from subscribing, that's the other way that you're going to help me to get to my first 1,000 subscribers. And I really want to get there, guys. So really, really help me, please. Right, I know you guys will do what you got to do. So thanks again for watching. I really hope you enjoyed, and see you next time for another episode of Let's Go. Let's go.